What's wrong with my eye? One of them is fine, but the other goes further back and has multiple layers to it. How do I treat this? Preferably non-surgical. I'm 19.
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a single photo, and you're 19 years old, and you're concerned about the appearance of your left eye. You describe multiple folds and the appearance, and you want to know if there's a non-surgical solution. Well, in the absence of a full exam, I would just say that I can certainly give you some guidance on what my impressions are based on this single photo. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and my initial impression by looking at this photo is that you have a condition called ptosis. Now, ptosis, specifically related to the eyelid, is referred to as eyelid ptosis, and in the greater likelihood that you've always had this appearance, it would be most likely something called congenital ptosis. Now, if it is newly acquired or acquired ptosis, well, then I would certainly advise you to very quickly seek a physician's for an examination, because that's unusual for somebody your age to suddenly have ptosis. But assuming that it's something that you've always had and may have gotten a little bit worse, I'll explain to you a little bit about what congenital ptosis is and then what the solutions are. To begin with, ptosis means droop, and that eyelid drooping is due to a maldevelopment or lack of proper development of a muscle called the levator muscle. Levator, like the word elevator, is the muscle that lifts the eyelid. Now, this muscle, when it doesn't develop properly, it doesn't work as well as a normal muscle. And what does a normal muscle do? It contracts and it relaxes. So therefore, this muscle will neither contract as strongly as a normal muscle, nor will it relax as a normal muscle. Now, when I do a ptosis evaluation, it's a fairly involved examination. It's basically taking measurements of the height of the eyelid, the amount of movement of the eyelid, and other ophthalmologic indications of the degree of eye function, and just to get a basic understanding as to how significant the ptosis is relative to how much it blocks your vision, as well as to the degree of the muscle action. Now, you asked if there's a non-surgical solution, and I would say simply that there isn't. In the past, in the distant past, people used to try to wear glasses and have something called an eyelid crutch, so that the eyelid would be pushed up with the glasses. Those tended not to work very, very well. That's the only non-surgical solution that even is even worth mentioning. There are situations where sometimes an eye drop for the purpose of pictures can cause contraction of another muscle that's in the eyelid called Mueller's muscle, so that the eyelid elevates slightly. That might be good for taking photos. But in terms of a more definitive solution, you're talking about a certain some kind of surgery. Now, typically, surgery for a muscle which has reasonable function is a procedure called levator resection, which is the muscle being shortened so that the eyelid is elevated. And then the alternative, if the eyelid muscle doesn't work very well at all and the eyelid is very droopy, there's a procedure called frontalis sling. And typically, people understand this because when their eyelid is drooping, they tend to raise their eyebrows to try to keep their eye open. Well, that surgery and that muscle that raises the eyebrow is called a frontalis muscle. So what we do surgically is we attach the muscle, the frontalis muscle, to the eyelid using a variety of different materials, everything from your own fascia, which is from your leg, to banked fascia, as well as other alternatives such as silicone and Gore-Tex. Now, these are all determined based on evaluation and consultation. So I would suggest that you meet with an oculoplastic surgeon and learn about your options. I would also encourage you to actually also see an ophthalmologist, get a proper eye exam, and determine if there's any other visual issues that can also be managed. Sometimes people, when they have congenital ptosis, if it blocks their vision for an extended period of time when they're very young, between 0 and 6, they can actually have a condition called amblyopia, where the eye, where the vision doesn't fully develop. So it's important that at least a proper eye exam be done before you undergo any eyelid surgery, and then you can actually have more comprehensive understanding of the eye health as well as the options for correction of this, of the eyelid drooping. So I'm sorry that there isn't a non-surgical option, but I think it's important that you understand the condition as well as what you should do to pursue the information you need to make an informed decision. So again, meeting with an ophthalmologist, an eye doctor, an MD who can evaluate your vision, evaluate your eye health, and then an oculoplastic surgeon who is an ophthalmologist who specializes and has additional training in plastic surgery of the eyes and face. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.